In this video, we are going to solve subjective questions of internet and intranet engineering asked by AKU in 2017 8 same exams.
Friends channel ko subscribe karo aur video ko share karo.
These are questions. Let us solve these questions. Question number 5. What is TCP/IP model? Explain the functions, protocols and services of each layer. Compare it with OSI model. Answer. TCP/IP stands for Transmission Control Protocol, Internet Protocol, and is a suite of communication protocols used to interconnect network devices on the Internet. TCP/IP is also used as a communications protocol in a private computer network, an intranet or extranet. The entire IP suite, a set of rules and procedures, is commonly referred to as TCP/IP. TCP and IP are the two main protocols, though others are included in the suite. The TCP/IP protocol suite functions as an abstraction layer between internet applications and the routing and switching fabric. TCP/IP specifies how data is exchanged over the internet by providing end-to-end communications that identify how it should be broken into packets, addressed, transmitted, routed and received at the destination. TCP/IP requires little central management and is designed to make networks reliable with the ability to recover automatically from the failure of any device on the network. The two main protocols in the IP suite serve specific functions. TCP defines how applications can create channels of communication across a network. It also manages how a message is assembled into smaller packets before they are then transmitted over the internet and reassembled in the right order at the destination address. IP defines how to address and route each packet to make sure it reaches the right destination. Each gateway computer on the network checks this IP address to determine where to forward the message. A subnet mask tells a computer, or other network device, what portion of the IP address is used to represent the network and what part is used to represent hosts, or other computers, on the network. Network address translation, NAT, is the virtualization of IP addresses. NAT helps improve security and decrease the number of IP addresses an organization needs. Common TCP/IP protocols include the following. Hypertext Transfer Protocol, HTTP, handles the communication between a web server and a web browser. HTTP Secure handles secure communication between a web server and a web browser. File Transfer Protocol handles transmission of files between computers. TCP/IP functionality is divided into four layers, each of which includes specific protocols. The application layer provides applications with standardized data exchange. Its protocols include HTTP, FTP, Post Office Protocol 3, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol and Simple Network Management Protocol. At the application layer, the payload is the actual application data. The transport layer is responsible for maintaining end-to-end communications across the network. TCP handles communications between hosts and provides flow control, multiplexing and reliability. The transport protocols include TCP and User Datagram Protocol, which is sometimes used instead of TCP for special purposes. The network layer, also called the Internet layer, deals with packets and connects independent networks to transport the packets across network boundaries. The network layer protocols are IP and Internet Control Message Protocol, which is used for error reporting. The physical layer, also known as the network interface layer or data link layer, consists of protocols that operate only on a link, the network component that interconnects nodes or hosts in the network. The protocols in this lowest layer include Ethernet for local area networks and address resolution protocol. The various services provided by the TCP to the application layer are as follows. Process-to-process communication. TCP provides process-to-process communication, i.e., the transfer of data takes place between individual processes executing on N systems. This is done using port numbers or port addresses. Port numbers are 16-bit long that help identify which process is sending or receiving data on a host. Stream-oriented. This means that the data is sent and received as a stream of bytes, unlike UDP or IP that divides the bits into datagrams or packets. However, the network layer that provides service for the TCP sends packets of information, not streams of bytes. Hence, TCP groups a number of bytes together into a segment and adds a header to each of these segments and then delivers these segments to the network layer. At the network layer, each of these segments are encapsulated in an IP packet for transmission. The TCP header has information that is required for control purpose, which will be discussed along with the segment structure. Full duplex service. This means that the communication can take place in both directions at the same time. Connection-oriented service. Unlike UDP, TCP provides connection-oriented service. It defines three different phases. Connection establishment, data transfer, connection termination. Reliability. TCP is reliable as it uses checksum for error detection. Attempts to recover lost or corrupted packets by retransmission, acknowledgement policy and timers. It uses features like byte number and sequence number and acknowledgement number so as to ensure reliability. Also, it uses congestion control mechanisms. Multiplexing. TCP does multiplexing and the multiplexing at the sender and receiver ends respectively as a number of logical connections can be established between port numbers over a physical connection. TCP, IP, OSI. TCP refers to Transmission Control Protocol. OSI refers to Open Systems Interconnection. TCP, IP has 4 layers. OSI has 7 layers. TCP, IP is more reliable. OSI is less reliable. TCP, IP does not have very strict boundaries. OSI has strict boundaries. TCP, IP follow a horizontal approach. OSI follows a vertical approach. TCP, IP uses both session and presentation layer in the application layer itself. OSI uses different session and presentation layers. TCP, IP developed protocols then model. OSI developed model then protocol. Transport layer in TCP, IP does not provide assurance delivery of packets. In OSI model, transport layer provides assurance delivery of packets. Question number 6A. Describe the working of ARP and RARP protocol. Answer. Address Resolution Protocol, ARP, is a protocol or procedure that connects an ever-changing Internet Protocol, IP address to a fixed physical machine address. Also known as a Media Access Control, MAC address, in a local area network, LAN. This mapping procedure is important because the lengths of the IP and MAC addresses differ. And a translation is needed so that the systems can recognize one another. The most used IP today is IP version 4, IPv4. An IP address is 32 bits long. However, MAC addresses are 48 bits long. ARP translates the 32-bit address to 48 and vice versa. There is a networking model known as the Open Systems Interconnection, OSI, model. First developed in the late 1970s. The OSI model uses layers to give IT teams a visualization of what is going on with a particular networking system. This can be helpful in determining which layer affects which application, device, or software installed on the network, and further, which IT or engineering professional is responsible for managing that layer. The MAC address is also known as the data link layer, which establishes and terminates a connection between two physically connected devices so that data transfer can take place. The IP address is also referred to as the network layer or the layer responsible for forwarding packets of data through different routers. ARP works between these layers. What does ARP do and how does it work? When a new computer joins a local area network, LAN, it will receive a unique IP address to use for identification and communication. Packets of data arrive at a gateway, destined for a particular host machine. The gateway, or the piece of hardware on a network that allows data to flow from one network to another, asks the ARP program to find a MAC address that matches the IP address. The ARP cache keeps a list of each IP address and its matching MAC address. The ARP cache is dynamic. But users on a network can also configure a static ARP table containing IP addresses and MAC addresses. ARP caches are kept on all operating systems in an IPv4 Ethernet network. Every time a device requests a MAC address to send data to another device connected to the LAN, the device verifies its ARP cache to see if the IP to MAC address connection has already been completed. If it exists, then a new request is unnecessary. However, if the translation has not yet been carried out, then the request for network addresses is sent, and ARP is performed. An ARP cache size is limited by design, and addresses tend to stay in the cache for only a few minutes. It is purged regularly to free up space. This design is also intended for privacy and security to prevent IP addresses from being stolen or spoofed by cyber attackers. While MAC addresses are fixed, IP addresses are constantly updated. In the purging process, unutilized addresses are deleted. So is any data related to unsuccessful attempts to communicate with computers not connected to the network or that are not even powered on. RARP is abbreviation of Reverse Address Resolution Protocol, which is a protocol based on computer networking which is employed by a client computer to request its IP address from a gateway servers. Address Resolution Protocol Table or Cache. The network administrator creates a table in gateway router, which is used to map the MAC address to corresponding IP address. This protocol is used to communicate data between two points in a server. The client doesn't necessarily need prior knowledge the server identities capable of serving its request. Medium access control, MAC, addresses requires individual configuration on the servers done by an administrator. RARP limits to the serving of IP addresses only. When a replacement machine is set up, the machine may or might not have an attached disk that may permanently store the IP address, so the RARP client program requests IP address from the RARP server on the router. The RARP server will return the IP address to the machine under the belief that an entry has been set up within the router table. working of RARP. The RARP is on the network access layer and is employed to send data between two points in a very network. Each network participant has two unique addresses, IP address, a logical address, and MAC address, the physical address. The IP address gets assigned by software, and after that the MAC address is constructed into the hardware. The RARP server that responds to RARP requests can even be any normal computer within the network. However, it must hold the data of all the MAC addresses with their assigned IP addresses. If a RARP request is received by the network, only these RARP servers can reply to it. The info packet needs to be sent on very cheap layers of the network. This implies that the packet is transferred to all the participants at the identical time. The client broadcasts a RARP request with an Ethernet broadcast address and with its own physical address. The server responds by informing the client its IP address. Question number 6b. What do you mean by web directory? How will you make a search through a web directory? Answer. Web directory is a website or web page that includes a list of links to other sites that fit into a relevant topic. These directories were especially prevalent in the early days of the internet. Before individuals could simply find what they were looking for via a search engine, a web directory would be applicable for any type of industry or business type. These links could all apply to retail, or they could include services like dentists and doctors. In other words, there's no clear and definitive format or topics. Rather, web directories can be broad, making them important for any types of businesses. There are two ways to find information on the web: by searching or browsing. Web directories provide links in a structured list to make browsing easier. Many web directories combine searching and browsing by providing a search engine to search the directory. Unlike search engines, which base results on a database of entries gathered automatically by web crawler, most web directories are built manually by human editors. Many web directories allow site owners to submit their site for inclusion and have editors review submissions for fitness. Web directories may be general in scope or limited to particular subjects or fields. Entries may be listed for free or by paid submission, meaning the site owner must pay to have his or her website listed. Most web directories list websites by subject, which is why they're often called subject directories. A real person, not a software program, identifies which websites should be included in the list on a per-site basis, meaning that the entire directory is chosen by hand. For content to be added to a web directory, the owner has to manually include the link, title, and any other information they want included in the listing. Depending on how the web directory works, the owner might also let other website owners request that their site be added to the directory. Web directory submissions might be a free option or, depending on the directory, something that requires payment. When you come upon a website directory, there are usually two ways to find content: browse and/or search. Categories are often used to separate different sites and better organize the directory, but there's usually also a search engine built in that lets you search through the whole website.